If you're running the latest update to Fallout 4 on the Steam Deck, then you may have noticed that opening the game like normal does not bring you to the launcher anymore. This new update has preconfigured the game so that it will run with settings that Bethesda believes is optimal for the Steam Deck. But I know that there are going to be a large number of people who want to set things up themselves. Maybe you want to set up your own anti-aliasing setting, or maybe you want to manually configure the texture options. Whatever the reason, this can be done with Fallout 4 on the Steam Deck. So first, we're going to select the gear icon on the right side of the page, and then choose Properties. Now, we're going to tap right and then begin scrolling through this General tab, until you see the Launch Options field. Make sure that that option is highlighted and press the A button to bring up the keyboard. And in the Launch Options field, type out the following: Steam Deck with S and D capitalized equals 0 space percentage command percentage. Once that's done, we're going to press B to back out of the keyboard. We're going to press B again to back out of this side of that tab, and then we're going to press B again to bring us back to the game page. Now, whenever we load up the game, as long as everything was entered in correctly, we're now going to see the launcher for Steam Deck instead of Fallout 4 opening up. So we're going to now press the Steam button down here and then use the right trackpad to control the mouse. Then we're going to use R2 as a mouse click. And now you can configure Fallout 4 exactly how you want. So from here, again, we need to hold down the Steam button and then use the right trackpad to control the mouse. So we can change the resolution, the anti-aliasing option, the filtering option, the level of detail. We can go advanced and change things like view distance, texture quality, shadow quality. So maybe you don't care for shadows and you want to bring that down and you're willing to drop that to increase the FPS. We can specifically customize Fallout 4 on the Steam Deck exactly how we want through this launcher instead of just launching it like normal. Now, once you are done and you've configured it exactly how you want, we're just going to click on OK. And then from here, we can either play or we can exit. And I actually recommend that we exit from here, so that we can then go back to the properties area and then again go down here to the launch options area. And now this time, delete everything from here. Since everything that we set will remain in place as long as the game update doesn't make any changes to the configuration file, we no longer have to go into the launcher again. So then we just back out of that launch options, delete everything, go back, and then play the game. And now that we have removed those launch options parameters, whenever we launch Fallout 4, it's going to bring us directly into the game. So if you want, you could keep those launch options in place, and then it will always bring you to the launcher before you start to play Fallout 4. However, you could just make the changes to the launcher that you want, then remove the launch options field, and then never have to worry about that again. There are a number of issues still being reported for Fallout 4 on the Steam Deck, and I would like to cover all of those workarounds in the near future. I have a few of these videos that I have planned specifically for this big Fallout 4 update, but if you're still having trouble with the game, then let us know about it in the comment section below. I realize that a new Proton update did fix a lot of the bugs that had been reported immediately after the big update was released, so many of those widespread issues should now be fixed. But if you're looking for help with a certain bug, then definitely use the comment section to let me know about it, and we'll try to help you out if we're able to.